Next topic is departmentation. So in this video, I am going to present two topics here. One is departmentation, another one is span of control under unit number 3. Meaning of departmentation. What do you mean by departmentation? Departmentation means dividing a particular work into smaller number of units and then regrouping them into bigger unit based upon the similarity feature. And you know very well, there will be a person in charge for a department is known as departmental manager. The purpose of the departmentation is to increase the scope of the organization with respect to growth and expansion. There are two forms of departmentation. One is called functional departmentation. Second one is called divisional departmentation. What do you mean by functional departmentation? Functional departmentation means grouping certain activities with respect to similarity of the function is called functional departmentation. For example, activities connected with the manufacturing concern. You take a manufacturing industry. So what are the similarities of function means production, finance, personnel, and sales. If you take a trader, the major activity will be buying and selling. If you take a banker, the major activity will be borrowing and lending. Similarly, grouping the activity with respect to similarity of the function is called functional departmentation. Figure 1 shows the chart regarding functional departmentation. You can see board of director. There are 4 general manager, GM production, GM finance, GM personnel, and GM marketing. You can see GM production further subdivided into 3 section: production control, manufacturing, and purchasing. Similarly, finance, personnel, and marketing also decompose into further 3 smaller components like capital budgeting, current asset and budget, etc. The advantages of functional departmentation. When you see the advantages, it is very simple. Specializations are available. Training and control is available. Supervision is available. Very much suitable for stabilized organization. That means organization willing to run for a longer period as well as for smaller organization, this is well suitable. Demerits of functional departmentation. Demerits means delayed decision, holding of accountability, unsuitable for a dynamic organization. There is a complexity among all activities connected in a company. These are the limitations of functional departmentation. Now, the second departmentation, divisional departmentation, further subdivided into a number of classification called product departmentation, process departmentation, customer departmentation, geographical departmentation, departmentation with respect to time, size, and the task force. The first type, product departmentation. This is suitable for the company that produces multiple product, not only one product, more than one product. Companies, for those companies and all, it is very much suitable. Grouping of the jobs and the sources required for different product manufacture in a company. The chart shows the structure of a product departmentation. You can see board of director, GM production, GM finance, GM personnel, GM marketing, and directly the board of director is controlling manager A, manager B, and manager C. And each and every manager comes across a group of similar activity: production, finance, accounting, and R&D. Such a departmentation is called product departmentation. Advantages and disadvantages of product departmentation. When you see the merits, performance is better, flexibility is available, decision can be taken in a faster rate, there is so much coordination, control is available, responsibility is there, efficiency of the organization is also good. But when you see the demerits, expensive, it is more expensive when compared to product departmentation. Then comes process departmentation. Process departmentation means one particular product passes through different stages of production, and each and every stage they call it as a process, and the departmentation is called process departmentation. You can see the chart of process departmentation. You can see that board of director, four classification, production, finance, personnel and marketing. But when you see the production, it is divided into a number of activity: manager crushing, manager making pulp, purifying the pulp, paper roll and cutting. This is used for paper cutting or manufacturing in the manufacturing of paper industry. Merits and demerits of process departmentation. Specializations are available, economical considerations are there, technological considerations are there, training facility is provided. Boredom is the demerit of process departmentation. Customer departmentation. This sort of departmentation structure is available to meet the requirements of the customer. So based upon that, this structure has been formed. Organizing of the jobs and the resources in such a way, department should understand and respond to different requirement of the specific customer group. Such a structure is called customer departmentation. Chart showing customer departmentation. You can see the managing directors controlling four managers. One manager responsible for the car loan, second manager for the housing loan, third manager for the electronic loan, fourth one for commercial loan. Each and every manager responsible to respond to the customers in the market. Merits and demerits of customer departmentation. Competition is available, customer orientation is there, specialization is also available. But identification of the consumer group is a little bit big task. Change in the consumer behavior, it has to be identified and appropriately implemented. Specialized faculty should be available. Geographical departmentation. It is also called territorial departmentation. This departmentation has been arranged in such a way, very closer to the customer, even though dispersed over the different area and near the sources of the deposits available. Chart showing geographical departmentation. Again, there is a board of director, managing director. Managing director controlling three managers ABC. Each and every manager with respect to similar activity, a group of similar activity, production, purchase, personnel and marketing. Merits and demerits of geographical departmentation. Training and development facilities available, customer orientation is available, low cost, good communication is there. But when you see the demerits, such a coordination and control is not available, very expensive, manager skill is expected more. Departmentation by time. Now people have to work and shift, they have to work with respect to time interval. Such a departmentation structure is called departmentation by time. Machine cannot be stopped, demand is very high, machine has to work for a very longer period. Examples for departmentation by time is airlines and railway. They have to work round the clock, and these services are essential in nature, and they have to work and shift. Such a structure is called departmentation by time. Departmentation by size and the task force. The first one is departmentation by size. The second one is by force. Departmentation by size, the structure is implemented depending upon the number of employees working in an organization. And this one depends upon the nature nature of the project taken by the organization. The task force will be implemented. Each and every task will be consisting of people from different unit with a different skill. They have to carry out the project. Next topic is span of control. Span of control means the control hierarchy from the top level to bottom level in an organization is called span of control. So how many number of people reporting to one manager? For example, lesser number of people are reporting to one manager or more number of people reporting to one manager. Based upon that, the span of control will be implemented. Span of control. The span of control, three types of superiors are available. Direct single relationship, direct group relationship. The third one is cross relationship. Factors affecting span of management. Capacity of the superior, capacity of the subordinate. Subordinate means employees working under the superior. Then what is the nature of the task allocated? Degree of decentralization, degree of planning, communication technique, staff assistant, supervision from others. So there are two types of span of management. See, span of management and span of control, both are same. Types of span of management, two types are available. One is called narrow span of management. Second one is called wide span of management. Narrow span of management means a single manager or a supervisor controlling only a fewer number of people, which is also called tall organizational structure. Wide span of management, a single manager or supervisor controlling a larger number of people. The structure is called flat structure. When see the diagram of low span of control or tall hierarchy, one tall manager, one manager controlling two manager, this manager controlling two other supervisor, each and every supervisor controlling two other employee. So this hierarchy is called tall hierarchy. One person will be controlling only a fewer number of people in this hierarchy. That is why it is called low span of control. Flat hierarchy, which is also called wide span of control. Here, one manager is decomposed into six divisional manager, and each manager will be controlling eight number of people under their span. So span of control is wider, so it is called wide span of control. Advantages and disadvantages of low span of control or tall structure. First of all, there is a close supervisory control because low span of manager is available. More authorized structure. Responsible person is accountable to higher authority. Enhance the control of the top regulation over the organization. Demerits of tall structure. Employees are not that much motivated to the expectation level. Decision making is very slower. Communication barriers are available between the upper and the lower management. Benefits and rewards are given in a lesser manner to the tall organization. Advantages of the flat structure. Flat structure, it is less costlier because fewer number of managers available. Quickly decisions can be arrived. Very fast and clear communications are available. Subordinates are closer. Subordinates are free from close and strict supervision and control. Superior may not be that much dominating. Disadvantages of flat structure. There are more chances for the loose control because many subordinates are under one manager. Discipline is very bad. Relationship between the superior and the subordinate may not be good. Informal, close and informal relation may not be possible. Quality of performance overall may be bad. Which approach seems to be better? Narrow span of management is more costlier when compared to wide span of management because larger number of superiors or managers are connected with the narrow span of management. For example, you take same number of worker requirement for a supervisory personnel. 1,365 employees can be controlled by four manager under flat structure, or wider span of control, but 585 people or employees can be controlled by 8 number of managers under low span of control or tall structure. So therefore, looking into the cost of employment of the personnel availability, it is highly preferable to go for wide span of management. So these are the two topics I have presented here. One topic is departmentation, and the second one is span of control, which comes under unit number 3. Thank you.